What is your designation?
Say what?
He wants to know your name.
Here's my card. Sorry, I didn't see you there. I'm here to explain to you the meaning of the last scene. This scene takes place in a limousine on the way to Oscar's father's funeral. By portraying this scene, we are able to show you some of Oscar's personality, including how he has odd mental characteristics which cause him to come off as weird. It also shows his imaginative and childish mind by pretending to be his idol, Stephen Hawking.
Turn on the oven to 325 degrees Fahrenheit. Line the baking pan with foil, letting foil go up a little bit over the edges of the pan. And oh there. It's nice to see you again. Hold up. The previous scene shows Oscar playing Flight of the Bumblebee on his tambourine. One symbol that becomes very important to Oscar is his tambourine. The tambourine symbolizes a way for Oscar to cope with the problems that he has, while also acting as an object that makes him feel comfortable in any situation.
Once upon a time, New York City had a sixth borough. Oscar, I'm trying to tell you a story. Turn that off. Once upon a time, New York City had a sixth borough.
What's a borough?
That's what I call an interruption. Okay, I will continue now. Well, you won't read about it in any of the history books, because there's nothing, save for the circumstantial evidence in Central Park, which makes its existence very easy to dismiss. But even though most people will say they have no time to believe in the sixth borough, or they don't believe in the sixth borough, they still use the word believe.
Have I been to another borough?
You've been to multiple boroughs. The five boroughs, right now, are Manhattan, Brooklyn, Queens, Staten Island, and the Bronx. You were at the Bronx Zoo a few years ago. Well, so sixth borough left.
Oh, you're here again. Hold on. That scene allowed you to hear the bedtime story told to Oscar the day before the worst day. The most important message of this story is the piece about the message through the cat. The message symbolizes the words Oscar wanted to hear from his father, but never did, which were, "I love you." This message also serves as a parallel to the real-life story going on in Oscar's head.
So, did you hear what happened?
Yeah.
Did you hear from Mom or Dad? What'd she say?
Everything will be okay, and she'll be home soon. Dad will be home soon, too.
That's good.
This scene showed the day of 9/11, in which Oscar's grandma finds him under his bed. We not only once again see into Oscar's emotions, but we also see how he deals with death. He chooses to seclude himself
from everyone else, like on Hunter's bed, which shows the depression forming from the current events. This seclusion shows up many more times throughout the novel in physical and emotional forms.
Do you know Thomas Shell?
No, I don't. I'm sorry.
Do you know anything about the key?
What key? I don't know what you're talking about.
Is that a picture of an elephant crying?
Yeah, it is.
You know, that's physically impossible. Humans are the only things that can cry.
Really? I did not know that.
Well, it's true. So do you know anything about the key?
I already told you I don't. I'm sorry, I can't help you.
Do you know anything about Thomas Shell?
No.
Do you know anything about the key?
No. I've been a war reporter for all my life, but the biggest battle I've ever been a part of is cutting down a tree in Central Park.
Okay. Hello. Hello, Mr. Black.
Hello, Oscar.
Do you know anything about the key?
Well, actually, it's my key. I met your dad at a garage sale a couple years ago, and I've been searching for you ever since.
Bread fresh from the oven, not fresh from the truck. Baker's Delight, fresh to your table, guaranteed.
How did you meet him?
Well, my father was running a garage sale a couple years ago, and we sold a blue vase to him, and it had a key in it, and it was a key to our safe deposit box. So I was looking for the key so I could see what was in the safe deposit box, because my father passed away.
So the key was not mine?
No, it was mine.